Welcome to the lecture. In today's video lecture, we will see a pandas library. How to create a series and data frames in pandas and what are the key features of pandas. So that we will see in our today's video lecture. So for the data science, there are three most important library. That is the NumPy library, pandas library and matplot.pyplot library. Today we will see one of the library, that is the pandas, because it is an important one. NumPy and matplot library we will see as our implementation begins. So starting with the features of pandas, so what pandas library can do in the data science? So pandas library can handle the lots of data by creating the series and the data frame as an object. Pandas can do alignment and indexing. So if you want to do the alignment of the data, or if you want to provide the labeling of the data, then pandas library gives the functionality of doing that. Then comes the handling missing data. Pandas library are able to handle the missing data. They have the different functions, or we can say the method within the pandas library, and we can use that method to remove the missing data or to handle the missing data. Next is cleaning up data. So like we just said, that data can be very crude. So pandas library can also help to clean up the data. So we have already seen the data science pipeline. Over there, there was a step, that is the pre-processing or cleaning the data. So over here, the pandas library helps for preparing the data. Next comes input and output tools. So there are inbuilt tools for the purpose of reading and writing data in the pandas. So it would probably take a lot of code to generate the same result, whereas the processing in pandas is very fast. Then next comes multiple file formats supported. As we move further, we will see tomorrow that in tomorrow's video lecture, you will read a file. So you will read a comma separated file. You will read Excel file also. You can read JSON file also, and you can read flat files also. So there are multiple files formats supported by the pandas library. Pandas can do merging and joining of the data set. It might happen that there are two different data sets, but for the analysis purpose, you want to join that two data set. So the merging and the joining functionality is provided by the pandas. Then comes the optimized performance. So panda is having the optimized performance. The critical code for the pandas library is written in C language, or which makes it extremely responsive and fast. So this pandas library is used in Python language, but originally this pandas library is written in C. So it is giving an optimized performance. Pandas library has the Python support. It also supports the functionality with NumPy and the matplot library. Then comes the visualization. Without visualization, your data analysis would make no sense. So pandas also provide the functionality related to the visualization. It means pandas library are also useful for generating various graphs. Then comes the unique data. Pandas library can help us to find out which unique data are present in your data set by using the function, that is column.unique function. Pandas can perform all mathematical operations on the data, whether you want to find mean, whether you want to find variance, whether you want to find median, whether you want to find maximum or minimum value, then mathematical operations are supported by the pandas library. So how to import pandas library into your Python? So this is the code, that is import pandas as pd. So what kind of data does pandas support? So the data that pandas support is the tabular data. It also supports the time series data. It also supports the arbitrary matrix data. This is the tabular data. It means there are some labels, that is the column names we can say, and there are some rows. So this is the tabular data. This is the matrix data. So here there are we can say the different row indexes and the columns. And this is the time series data. So in this date and time is present. So data set in pandas. So there are two types of major data set in pandas, that is the one dimensional data set and multi-dimensional data set. So one dimensional data set, so pandas support the series as an object. You already know that in Python what is class and object. So in pandas, if you want to create the one dimensional object, then the name is the series object. If in pandas you want to create the multi-dimensional object, then you have to create either the data frame or the panel data. So the data frame is the two dimensional data and the panel data is three dimensional data. But over here we have to deal with the series object, that is the one dimensional data, and the data frame as an object, that is the two dimensional data. So we will see today how to create the series object in pandas and how to create data frame in pandas. So first of all, if you want to create the series object, over here you have to create a one-dimensional labeled array. So we have already seen that what is list and array in Python. So over here I am creating one list, that is data equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. This is my list, and my object name, or you can say the variable name, is data. So if you want to create a series object in pandas, then you have to write the syntax like this, that is pd dot series, where s is capital, and into the bracket, that is as an argument, you have to pass this variable, that is the data, as the variable. So whatever the answer is, that will be stored in my new object, that is my series one as an object name, and I am printing this series one. Then you can see the output like this. So this is how the series object is created in pandas. Now the question is, you will ask that we already have a list and array in Python. Then why we are using this series in series features of the pandas? So the answer is, this series, that is the one dimensional array only, but it is very fast compared to the normal list and array which is available in Python. So we are using this series features of the pandas because for the analysis purpose it is very necessary that your computation is very fast. So this series object is very fast compared to the normal list and the arrays in Python. So let's see the practical implementation. So this is my notebook. Over here I have to first of all import the libraries. So for importing the libraries, you can import the libraries in three different ways. So you can write like this, that is the import pandas as pd, or you can write like this, that is import pandas, or you can write like this, that is from pandas import star. Just for an example, I am using the middle statement, that is import pandas. So I am commenting the above two statements. So for creating the series object, I have to write the whole name, that is pandas dot operator, and I have to write series, because this series is the method which is present within some class. So for that I have to compulsory call this method with the help of this dot operator. So this series method is the part of the pandas library. So I am writing like this, that is pandas dot and series method. As an argument, you can pass your data. So if I am writing my data is equals to this particular list, that is 1, 2, 3, 5, and this. So this is my list, and I can write the data like this. Or else you can pass this list directly as an argument. Now I am printing this S1. Then you can see over here that my series object is created, and this shows my row index, that is the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And this shows my values. And you can see over here that it is showing the type as integer 64. So this is my series object. So if you want to check the type, then you can write like this. That is print type of S1, like this. Then you can see that it is showing that it is object from the class, that is from the pandas core library, and it is the series object. But within the series, what type of elements are present? That is 1, 3, 4, 5. These all elements are of type integer 64. Now over here, suppose I am writing now the first statement, that is import pandas as pd. Now every time I have to write like this, that is the pandas dot series or pandas dot data frame. So this pandas is a very long name. So instead of that, I can make use of this alias. So this is my alias, that is spd. So wherever I want to write pandas, over there I can write like this, that is pd dot series, like this. So you can see that your code becomes normal. So for this, I have to run first this code, that is import pandas as pd. Now the alias has created. Now I am running this code, then you can see that your code is running successfully. Instead of pandas, now you can write the alias, that is pd. Now the next one is over here, that is pd.series. Now I am passing two different arguments. In the first argument, I am passing the values. In the second argument, I am passing the index name. Then I am printing my series object, that is S2. So you can write just S2 also, and you can write print S2 also. Then you can see over here, my values are same, but over here my index name has changed. Previously my index was the default index that starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 was my row index. Over here, I have given name to my row index, that is A, B, C, D, E. So you can see over here that over here I have given that D is first and C is next. So accordingly, you will get the index name, that is D is first, C is next. You can also give name to your series object. So I am giving the name. Then you can see over here, it is showing the name as values, that is VALS. So this is how you can create a one-dimensional object in pandas. So what is this series? It is the one-dimensional array, you can say, and it is the part of pandas. So you can say it as the series object. Now, next is what is a data frame? So data frame is the two-dimensional labeled data structures with columns of potential different types. So this is how the data frame looks like. It is a two-dimensional, so you have the row also and you have the column also. So it is called the two-dimensional. So it is one type of data structures, and whatever object you are creating, that object is called the data frame, which is the part of pandas library. So these are the key features of the data frame, that you can use the different column types. It is mutable size. Mutable means you can change the size of the data frame. It is the labeled axis, so it provides some label to the columns. It also provides arithmetic operations on rows and columns. If you want to do the sum of all the values, then this data frame is allowing you to do that. So how to create a data frame? You have to write the alias, or you can write the pandas, the whole name. So I'm writing the alias over here, that is pd dot, and I'm writing data frame like this. And into the bracket, you have to pass your data. So let's see how to create a data frame. So for creating a data frame, suppose I want to create an empty data frame. So I'm writing pd dot data frame as a function. And whatever the answer is that I am storing in my df object. So I am printing the df. So let's see, the output is like this, that is empty data frame is created. There are no columns and there are no index position. And what we are doing over here, we are just calling the data frame constructor. We are not doing anything over here. So the empty data frame is created. Next is creating a data frame from list. So this is my list variable. How to create a list in Python? You all know, that is by using the square bracket, you can create the list. So for converting this list into the data frame, what you have to do? You have to call this data frame constructor. That is, you can also say the constructor as the a special member of the class. So I'm writing the alias, that is pd.dataframe. As an argument, you have to pass this variable list, and you are printing this df. Then you can see that my data frame is created, and randomly this index position will be assigned. That is the index position of the rows from 0 to 6. And over here I have not provided the column name, so the column index is also 0. And whatever my values are, these values are showing like this. So this is how I am creating a data frame, that is the two dimensional. Now let's create the data frame using the dictionary. So how to create a dictionary in Python? We have already seen, suppose this is my dictionary as an object, or we can say is at the variable. This is my key, and these are my elements of the key. These are my different elements. These are my different elements of the key. So degree is again my key. These are the elements of the key, that is the MBA, BC, MTech, and MBA. Score is my key, and these are the elements of the key. So for creating a data frame, what we have to write? That is the alias pd.dataframe. As an argument, you have to pass this variable or object, you can say. So I am passing the dictionary, that is dict, and whatever the answer is, it will be stored in my new object, that is my df object, and I am printing this df. Then you can see over here that my two-dimensional data frame is created, and it is like the tabular column, you can say, tabular design, you can say. So whatever the key are in the dictionary, that will be my column name, and whatever the elements are, that will be my values within the columns. And what is this 0, 1, 2, 3? I have not given anywhere the 0, 1, 2, 3. So this 0, 1, 2, 3 will be provided by the data frame by default. And what are this? These are the row index, and which by default starts from 0, then 1, then 2, then accordingly, whatever the rows are, accordingly the row index are assigned. So this is my data frame. You can also create the data frame from the series object. So previously I have created one series object, that is S2. So I want to convert this now series object into my data frame. So I can write like this, that is S2.2_frame. So when I am writing this, and suppose I am storing this value in my new variable, that is df1. Why I am writing df? Because it is my data frame. So I am writing df, and I am printing this df1. Then you can see that my series object has converted into the data frame. So let's check whether the series object is converted into the data frame or not. So for that I will write print type of df1. Then you can see that over here it is showing the type, that is class, it is the pandas core frame, and it is of type data frame. So this is my object df1, it is of type data frame. So overall, at last, what you have to remember? You have to remember that series is the one-dimensional object of the pandas library, and data frame is the two-dimensional object of the pandas library. Tomorrow we will see in video lecture that how to read the data set, and whatever data set you are reading, that will be your data frame in pandas. So keeping it till here, thank you all.